Namaste. Welcome to the 16th episode of Logistically Speaking. Though the coronavirus continues its devastating impact on the world population, economies, and the livelihood, the past week gave us some much needed positive news. Pfizer, Moderna, Serum Institute, to name a few, have shared positive update on the progress in vaccine development. Currently, there are some 20 vaccines in the trial stage, of which there are 3 conducting phase 3 trials and have announced efficacy rate which is greater than 90%. However, a crucial factor in the success of these vaccines is their logistics. And that's what I will be discussing in today's episode. The progress in vaccine development is definitely a good news. However, we need to bear in mind that India is expecting the first batch of vaccine for distribution only by July 2021, and that too of 400 million doses, which can be enough for 200 million people. And for attaining herd immunity, we require to vaccinate 60% of the population, which will be 78 million people in India. The expected first load, which is enough for 200 million people, is planned to be distributed based on a priority list, so we can expect the vaccination process to be completed in India only by maybe the end of 2022 or by 2023. But as per some of the analysts, India's real capacity is only 15 million vaccine doses a month due to the lack of field staff and supporting facility, which can extend the vaccination process to take 2 years to cover maybe even 30% of the population. There will be numerous challenges along the way with regard to pricing, storage, distribution, and inoculation. But we will be focusing on the likely challenges with storage and distribution. And when it comes to storage, number one challenge is all the vaccine candidates required to be stored in extreme sub-zero temperatures, which India's cold chains cannot accommodate. And these are the temperature levels the major vaccines required to be stored at. Number one, Pfizer vaccine at minus 70 degrees Celsius, Sputnik V vaccine at minus 15 degrees Celsius, Oxford vaccine at minus 2 degrees Celsius to minus 8 degrees Celsius, Moderna vaccine at minus 20 degrees Celsius, and Genova Biopharma vaccine at minus 8 degrees Celsius. India claims to have 27,000 cold storage warehouses, but this can handle storage for temperature ranging from minus 2 to minus 8 degrees Celsius. And there are very few with the capacity to handle storage at minus 30 degrees Celsius. And number 3, resources required to build a new cold chain facility are time and cost intensive. And number 4, uninterrupted power supply will be required to maintain such storage facilities, which is a significant challenge in many parts of our country. In some areas, rather than transporting the vaccine to the people, transporting people to the vaccine centers might be much better solution. Hence, the need to build such centers and storage facilities. Lastly, there will be a need for round-the-clock security to safeguard vaccines against tampering and black marketeering. And in terms of challenges with the distribution, number one challenge is this will be the largest and most complex logistic operation which the world will undertake. Logistics companies will need to go back to the drawing board and re-evaluate processes and redesign innovative models to facilitate smooth transportation. And number 2, considering that most of the vaccines need to be stocked at sub-zero temperature, it will be a mammoth task to solve transportation challenges to rural parts of India. Depending on the vaccine being used in India, on an average, each individual will require 2 doses, and that would mean that planning transportation of 2.6 billion doses in total for India, while the world at large will need to plan for delivery of 15.6 billion doses at least, and I'm not factoring in some vaccines that require 3 doses to be administered. And number 4, selective delivery planned by India can result in each vaccine centers having to stay operational for longer. And number 5, not just in India, but governments worldwide need to re-establish air connectivity to pre-COVID level of 22,000 city pairs, which can take long time. And lastly, emergency procedures will need to be implemented at all borders to ensure speedy and priority movement for transport vehicles carrying vaccines. However, despite all these challenges, logistics companies have had enough lead time to plan and prepare for efficient storage and distribution. And to add to this, India has sufficient experience with mass distribution programs and is capable of reaching the far corners of the country. And with reasonably good rural health centers already in place, vaccine administration should be manageable, and just as we managed to eradicate polio. And we will be hopefully be able to do the same with COVID-19. And thank you for watching this video. Now, as you know, the second wave of pandemic has come in already. Stay safe and do not forget to wear the mask. And good to see you, and see you next week.